हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू पीआरवी सॉल्यूशन। सो इन दिस लेक्चर वी विल स्टडी द अल्टरनेटिंग करंट इंडिकेटिंग इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स। मूविंग आयरन इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स आर ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड इन अर्लियर पार्ट। सो नाउ वी विल स्टडी इलेक्ट्रो डायनोमीटर इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स विच इज आल्सो यूज फॉर एसी मेजरमेंट्स। सो व्हाट इज इलेक्ट्रो डायनोमिक टाइप इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स? द डेफिनेशन: इलेक्ट्रोडायनेमिक टाइप इंस्ट्रूमेंट इज यूज फॉर द मेजरमेंट ऑफ एसी एंड डीसी क्वांटिटीज, अनलाइक पीएमएमसी इंस्ट्रूमेंट विच कैन ओनली बी यूज फॉर मेजरमेंट ऑफ डीसी क्वांटिटीज। सो दे आर यूज फॉर एसी एंड डीसी क्वांटिटीज मेजरमेंट। दिस टाइप ऑफ इंस्ट्रूमेंट इज नोन एज इलेक्ट्रोडायनेमोमीटर टाइप इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स। इंट्रोडक्शन: इलेक्ट्रोडायनेमिक्स टाइप इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स आर सिमिलर टू पीएमएमसी टाइप एलिमेंट्स एक्सेप्ट दैट द मैग्नेट इज रिप्लेस्ड बाय टू सीरियली कनेक्टेड फिक्स्ड कोइल दैट प्रोड्यूसेस द मैग्नेटिक फील्ड व्हेन एनर्जाइज्ड। सो इन केस ऑफ पीएमएमसी वी आर यूजिंग देयर परमानेंट मैग्नेट, बट इन दिस केस इलेक्ट्रोडायनेमिक टाइप वी आर यूजिंग हेयर इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेट। द फिक्स्ड कोइल्स आर स्पेस्ड फार अपार्ट to allow passage of the shaft of the movable coil, as of the fixed coils we divided the fixed coil into two parts, and these fixed coils are much separated so that the movable coil will move freely in between the fixed coil. The movable coil carries a pointer which is balanced by counterweights. Its rotation is controlled by spring, so controlling torque is provided by springs, and this movable coil also have pointer attached to it which moves over a calibrated scale. And this the fourth point is the motor torque is proportional to the product of the current in the moving and fixed coil. So the torque here is proportional to the product of current and in the both the coils, moving and fixed coils. If the current is reversed, the field polarity and the polarity of the moving coil reverses at the same time. When we are reversing the current for AC, field polarity and polarity of the moving coil reverses at the same time, and the turning force continue in the original direction, means pointer will deflect in the same direction. This is the circuit diagram. This is the fixed coil which is divided into two parts, and this will carry a current I. So here in between these two fixed coil we are placing a movable coil. Magnetic field is set up by these two coils, will move this movable coil, and on this movable coil we have a pointer attached which moves over a calibrated scale. So this is the basic circuit of the electrodynamometer. Construction: it consists of two fixed coil, a moving coil, control spring, damping device, magnetic shielding arrangement. So we will discuss now fixed coil. Fixed coil is provide the sake of production of magnetic field. Fixed coils are used for providing this magnetic field. The fixed coil is divided into two sections so that uniform magnetic field may be achieved at the center. Further, the splitting up fixed coil in two sections facilitates passage of instrument's moving shaft. So these fixed coils are separated into two parts so that our moving iron or this movable coil moves in between them, and also they will provide uniform magnetic field. Moving coil is moving coil serves the purpose of converting the actuating quantity into readable value on the scale. So it will convert the actuating quantity, which can be current or voltage, into readable value on the scale. It is generally wound on a non-magnetic metallic former. So this will be mounted on non-metallic former. Metallic former shall never be used as it will lead to eddy current generation due to changing flux. So we will not use here metallic former because it will introduce losses. This eddy current will introduce inaccuracy as eddy current damping is not used in electrodynamic instrument. So they will introduce here inaccuracy. Damping. Air friction damping is employed in the electrodynamic type instrument. To provide air friction damping, a pair of aluminium vane is attached to the spindle at the bottom. So spindle on which the pointer is connected, this aluminium vane is attached to that spindle. These vanes move in a sector shaped chamber. The vane moves in a sector shaped chamber. The magnetic field produced by the fixed coil are very weak because of air cored coil. Because we are using air cored, so magnetic field is weak. Why shielding is used? The magnetic field in electrodynamic type instrument is very weak, of the order of 0.005 to 0.006 Weber per meter square. So it is very weak force. Therefore, it becomes very important to protect the instrument from the effect of external magnetic field. Because they are generating very weak force, so they must be protected from external magnetic field. To provide magnetic shielding, normally electrodynamic type instrument is enclosed in a high permeability alloy. So the casing used for provide shielding is of high permeability alloy. Working principle. Since the direction of current is changing in each half cycle, there will be a corresponding change in the direction of magnetic flux. If current will change its direction, then corresponding direction of flux will be also changed. Because of this change of magnetic flux, the torque on the moving coil will also change in each half of cycle of the AC quantity to be measured. So torque will also change. Suppose the torque on the moving coil for positive half cycle AC quantity is clockwise, then it will change to anticlockwise direction in the negative half cycle. Thus ideally the needle of PMMC instrument shall swing back and forth around the zero position. So this was the disadvantage of PMMC that is not used for measurement of AC, because its needle deflects or swing back and forth around the zero position when AC will apply it, because for positive half cycle the torque is clockwise and negative half cycle the torque is anticlockwise. But there is something called inertia, due to which inertia of instrument the needle cannot follow the rapid change in direction of torque at power frequency. Power frequency means high frequencies, and therefore merely vibrates around the zero position. So means inertia means law of inertia. It says that a body which is in rest, which is at rest, will remain at rest until external force will be applied on it. Now suppose if we were able to reverse the direction of magnetic flux each time the direction of AC quantity changes through the moving coil, then we can have a unidirectional torque. So in this way we get here a unidirectional torque for AC also. Thus we can measure the AC quantity. So this is the advantage of electrodynamometer instruments. Actually this method of reversing the magnetic flux is used in electrodynamometer type instrument by carefully observing the figure above. Notice that fixed coil as well as moving coil is in series. Therefore the direction of current in the moving coil is same as that in the fixed coil. So direction of current in the both the coil, moving coil and fixed coil, are same. This means that as the direction of magnetic field changes, the direction of current in the moving coil also changes. Thus the torque on the moving coil will not change, rather it will be unidirectional. because we are getting same polarity at the moving coil. So the torque will not on the moving coil will not change here. Rather, it will be or it will always be a unidirectional torque. So torque developed by EMMC, electromagnetic or electrodynamo-magnetic moving coil. So here this F1, F2 represents the fixed coil while this represents the moving coil. So we want to find the expression for torque. So this is the L1 is the self inductance of fixed coil, L2 is the self inductance of moving coil, where M is the mutual inductance between fixed coil and moving coil. I1 is the current passes through the fixed coil and I2 is the current passes through the moving coil. So total inductance of the system is L1 plus L2 plus twice M. But we know that in case of MI, TD is equal to half of I square DL by D theta. This is the torque equation for deflection in moving instrument. So L is here, L total. So we will put this total L here. We will get this expression half I square D by D theta L1 plus L2 plus twice of M. The value of L1 and L2 are independent of deflection, but M mutual inductance varies with theta. So TD is equal to half I square into twice of DM D theta. TD is equal to I square DM by D theta. As L1 and L2 are constant, their derivative becomes 0. So we have deflection torques is equal to I square DM by D theta. If the coils are not connected in series, means I1 is not equal to I2, then we will get this I square is separated into I1 and I2. So contouring torque, as we know that contouring torque is always equal to K theta. So this K theta becomes equal to this value and theta becomes equal to I1 I2 by K DM by D theta. So hence the deflection of pointer is proportional to the current passing through the fixed coil and the moving coil. So this deflection is proportional to the current passing through fixed and moving coil, means this is fixed coil current, this is moving coil current, or this deflection is proportional to the square of the current. So in this way we can calculate AC voltage or current from the EMMC. Thanks for watching.